With us in the studio is Bukidnon Representative Teofisto T. G. Gingona III. He's the son of former Vice President Teofisto Gingona, and he is running for Senator under the banner of the Liberal Party. Good morning and welcome to Head Start.
Good morning.
I know you turned 51 just a few days ago.
Oh, okay.
Belated happy birthday.
Thank you. Thank
How did you celebrate your birthday?
With heavy breakfast.
Heavy breakfast?
Yeah.
And what did you do? Do you still have time to spend with your family, considering the...
Well, right now it's pretty tight. Really, really tight.
Yeah.
But this morning, we were able to have breakfast. That's why it was more of a breakfast. Traditionally, it's dinner, but this time it was breakfast.
That was the only time you could squeeze
yes.
it in. All right. Now, you come from a family of politicians. Your father, we all know, is former vice president, also served as senator and served different positions in the Aquino administration. And your grandfather was also a politician. What was it like for you growing up as a Gingona and you know, belonging to a family of politicians?
It was quite interesting. And I was also into politics already, even during my student days in the Ateneo.
I heard you are an activist.
Yes. Not really the die-hard activist, but we did. And in fact, we even landed in jail in 1978 when we protested the 1978 Interim Batasan Pambansa elections. Together with me, we landed in jail in Bicutan because we were marching to protest the elections. Then the COMELEC rounded us up. They rounded up my dad, me, my mom. I remember Joker Arroyo was with us, Nene Pimentel, Lorenzo Tanyada Sr., Soc Rodrigo. Jerry Treñas, who's now the mayor of Iloilo, was then the president of the student council. He was with us. The whole Ateneo Student Council at that time was rounded up. That was the time when Laban was born.
Mm-hmm.
So you have the L sign. It's not for liberal, but it's really for Laban.
Uh-huh.
Goes back all the way to 1978, Lakas ng Bayan, which was headed by Ninoy Aquino.
All right.
So this is really a sign against abuse of power and oppression.
All right. Now, prior to 2004, before you ran for Congress, we really didn't hear much about you. What were you doing prior to 2004?
Very, very private life. I was in business, principally real estate. So it was mostly private life, quiet private life.
And what made you transition from being a real estate person to being a politician? Was that just an afterthought, or did you always want to be in politics eventually?
No. After several years of being in business, after graduating from law school, I think around about 20 years, I said to myself, well, I'm okay already sa business, more or less stable naman. Okay naman my family. So the next is let's give it a try and try to help the nation.
Mm-hmm. So there's always something at the back of your head. You always wanted
back of my head.
To
yes,
be a politician.
Yes, it's always
as well.
Been there. But then priorities first. And since mukhang okay naman yung iba.
Mm-hmm.
So, nandito na tayo sa step 3.
Okay. So, in 2004, you ran for Congress and you ran for re-election and won again in 2007. We remember your very impassioned speeches in Congress, really moving to block charter change and also the
yes.
impeachment of the president. But what were your other advocacies apart from these ones?
Well, that's also my main platform now is the budget reform.
Mm.
Because very few people know what the budget is.
Mm.
Actually, the budget is the plan on how to spend the money of the people for the benefit of the people.
Mm-hmm.
Dapat.
Mm-hmm.
Number one, we have to make it understandable.
Mm-hmm.
There's too many technical language. There's too much technical language in the budget.
Mm-hmm.
Very few understand it. So we have to make it understandable. Let's simplify it, the language. Number two, there should be no secrets.
Mm-hmm.
Too much secrets. Too much secrecy. There's no transparency.
Mm-hmm.
Number three, we have to make it accountable. A lot of people spend people's money, but there is no public accountability.
Mm-hmm.
And fourth, there should be public participation. Of course, Congress is being representatives of people are there, but I would like to broaden the participation to people's organization and governmental organization and the people. After all, it's their money. They should have a say in it.
Now, a lot of the bills that you filed in Congress do have to do with the budget and budget reform. But what's going to happen if you, you know, leave Congress now and then move to the Senate, or if you don't even make it to the Senate? What's going to happen to those bills?
Well, I can refile it in the Senate. Mm-hmm. And we do have counterpart legislators in Congress who can continue the fight. Erin Tanyada is there. He's running now unopposed, so I'm sure he'll be around. Mm-hmm. And he's one of my partners there when it comes to budget reform.
All right.
So on both houses, if we both enter, then it will continue. The budget reform process will continue.
All right. Now, we heard very early last year that you were running for senator. And when initial reports came out, you were running for senator under the Nacionalista Party.
Mm-hmm.
What happened? Why did you leave the party?
Well, when Noynoy declared he was going to run, I believe that Noynoy was best suited for meaningful change and principled reform. Noynoy and I grew up halos together. Mm. We were together Ateneo Grade School, Ateneo High School, Ateneo College. Mm-hmm. And even during the, during the martial law years, mm-hmm. his father and my father, his family and my family were oppressed.
Mm-hmm.
And our fathers both fought against the abuse of power and mm-hmm. oppression.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a shared experience, the same principles. I remember pa nga when every Friday we were in high school, diba? Every Friday, being teenagers, you want to go to parties, you mm-hmm. want to go out on dates, mm-hmm. your gimmicks, whatever. Mm-hmm. What happened here is while they were preparing for their parties and dates, kami, Ninoy, we prepare to go to visit our fathers. He would visit Ninoy Aquino in Fort Bonifacio. Okay. I would visit Tito Gingona in Campo Crame.
So your relationship really goes way
back. Yes, it goes back. So,
how does that leave your relationship with Senator Villar? Did you part on good terms?
Nagpaalam naman ako na maayos. Yes.
Okay. Now that you hear all these reports of Lakas officials leaving the party and moving to the Nacionalista Party, what goes on in your head? Because you left the Nacionalista Party and moved to the Liberal Party.
Yes, it just goes to show that politics is very fluid, mm-hmm. and that a lot of things will change, especially this next last 2 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
Kung sa basketball, di ba, last 2 minutes ba yun, last 3 minutes?
Dami pang pwede mangyari.
Yeah.
What do you think?
This is the time. Well, we'll see. It's going to be exciting. I cannot predict.
All right. Now, with the Liberal Party, once you joined, we saw all these ads. We've seen your Galitza Buaya ad, very catchy. But also now you have a new endorser, Chris Aquino, very effective as an endorser for whatever, be it products or politicians. Did you have to seek her endorsement for that, or do you have to pay her for that ad? Or
no, that was help. That was help. Tulong talaga ni Chris sa akin. Tulong ng pamilya Aquino
mm-hmm.
sa akin. There was no consideration involved.
Now,
they just wanted to help me. And I thank them very much for that. I'm really very grateful.
Okay. You've also been consistently in the top 12 in the surveys for different survey companies. But how do you respond to those who would say that the reason that you're in the top 12 is because matunog yung pangalang Gingona, and it's a name that your father made more than they give more credit to what the name that your father built?
Of course, you cannot deny. You cannot deny. But you know, 60% of the voters are between 30 and below. Mm.